next, Trisha?
Tell the truth next! Tell us what you're doing!
Don't interrupt me, the king is talking.
Shocking guest update.
She comes to you and she says, I want to be a man.
Yes.
They're back, and Tom has something to reveal.
We're definitely going to get a divorce.
What?
It's going to be a whole lot sooner than he wants it to be.
Did teen mom Deborah make a change?
I drink so I throw up, then I drink some more.
Updates on our most memorable guests. Next, Trisha.
We built a studio, and the audience came. We built a show, and the guests came. You believe it or not?
You're not learning.
We've had drama.
You can't see your mum, you can't talk on the phone, you can't do nothing.
We've had tears.
I don't want to tell them.
Can I talk with you? But you know what? We've had growth, and we've had resolution.
Do you want to stay with him or not?
I apologize for the thing I put you through.
So you asked for updates? Well, we've got updates. Shocking guest updates. King JB believed women were put on this earth to serve men.
I do things that you can't do. Not even you, Trish.
So is he still treating his wife like a second-class citizen?
I'm King JB. This is my queen, Chrissy.
Deborah was a wild teen mom.
Is it true what you told me that you hit your grandmother?
She got in the way, and she got hit.
She's back. Has she changed since the show? Alicia found out her stripper fiancé was getting paid for sex.
You prostituted yourself.
Their update is outrageous.
I know you guys are all wondering if John and I stay together.
Tom's wife, April, transformed herself into a man named Logan. Today, they both returned.
Tom has an announcement to make about the state of his marriage.
Shocking guest updates.
The Trisha Show starts now.
Shocking guest updates.
Our Facebook page and our website are exploding with comments and requests for guest updates. On a show entitled I Am the King, My Wife Will Obey Me, we met a woman named Robbie. Now, Robbie's boyfriend, Chris, was such an abusive bully. One time he actually made her eat her dinner off the floor. Watch. Has he ever been physically abusive to you?
He kicked me in my face a couple of times.
One time you cooked a dinner he didn't like. He threw the lasagna on the floor.
It wasn't hot enough. He got real mad and he threw it on the floor. He said, you know what? You can lay your hands on me and say, you eat it. I just fell on the floor and I ate it.
Does he do this in front of your daughter?
Yes, it had been a couple of times that he did it in front of her.
You scared of him?
Call Robbie a hoe, a whore. I call her whatever I feel like that's what she is at that time. If more men discipline their women, it wouldn't be so damn disrespectful.
What are the rules that you have for Robbie?
You can't go nowhere, you can't see your mama, you can't talk on the phone, you can't do nothing.
If you want sex, she's gonna drop whatever she does.
Yeah, if I want her right then and there, she gotta stop whatever she's doing and give me what I want. I gotta lay down rules.
Last night, we had a hidden camera in your green room while you were in our offices. Now, apparently, you wanted Robbie to hand over the money we gave her for food. Check this out. How do you feel when you see that?
I feel that's what it's supposed to be. That's how it's supposed to go around.
Well, as you just heard, Chris was behaving this way in front of their young daughter, Egypt. So after the show, with the help of age progression technology, I showed Chris a picture of what the future could have in store for his baby girl if he continued to abuse Robbie. Watch this.
That's your little girl?
Yeah, that's Egypt.
You know that little girl who come from homes where there is some violence done against the woman? They tend to get into similar relationships themselves, okay? You need to be prepared for this.
I didn't want to get that far with her.
Yeah, she's learning.
My sister died like that. Her boyfriend shot her in the head with a gun.
Do you swear you will change things?
Yeah, I swear I'll change things.
You out of control equals that.
I'm ready to change. I apologize
think they stayed together? Now, although Chris promised to change after that show, something changed in Robbie too. She decided that she no longer wanted to be with Chris. Yep, they've now broken up. Okay, on that same show, we met a man named JB, along with having a very interesting philosophy on life, also gave himself a very interesting nickname. Take a look. Yeah, how come you call yourself King JB?
It's what other people call me. It's a rank. It's what I've earned, you know, for the last 15 years.
Tell me about your belief in women not being equal to men.
At the end of the day, I do things that you can't do. You don't do things that I can't do. Not even you, Trish.
And what about sex? When you say so?
I mean, I don't really care about that. When it comes to sex, you know, that's how, I mean, that's something I would love from her if she doesn't have to work.
Yes.
And with me, I value myself. I value my penis, so to speak. So the bottom line, you go sleep alone, cry about it.
Do you approve of her friends?
No, and I need to approve for they call the phone that I pay for or knock at the door that I pay for, period.
What about your kids? You teach them this stuff as well?
And the last thing I want is for them to drop out of high school, miss college because some whole other kid, that they couldn't control themselves.
Have you heard the term chauvinist pig?
Absolutely.
Are you a chauvinist?
Yes.
Meet JB's queen, Chrissy, and hear how she felt about JB's commands.
What I don't like about JB's controlling ways is when he's name-calling. When he's calling me bitch, retard, stupid. Sometimes, you know, I feel like I try my best to do what it is he wants me to do, and sometimes I just feel like it's not good enough.
Is he your king?
He's my king, but I'm not gonna take being called stupid. I'm not gonna take being called a retard. Because you know why? I'm not. I am.
His son Daniel to follow in his male chauvinist footsteps. Now have a look at what happened when our executive producer Paul sat down with 9-year-old Daniel.
What does King JB teach you about women?
That they should be at home cooking dinner and cleaning.
Do you believe in God?
Now, the self-proclaimed God, the creator, said you would give a shelter and food. He hasn't done that. There's still a lot of homeless people and starving people. He gives me shelter and food. Therefore, he is God.
You think that the women in America should be more like the women in Saudi Arabia?
Yes. The women are loving. They clean the house. They get executed for hoeing. And as good one.
You were actually applauding?
Absolutely. What he is saying is that the values are different. Women understand. Walk on the other side. Come in your face up. You know what I'm saying?
And you feel good hearing your son talk like that?
Well, no, of course not.
Does he brainwash you?
No.
No.
Christine claims she was not brainwashed, but she did tell us she wished JB would change. So they sent us this video update. Watch this.
I'm King JB, this is my queen Chrissy. Since coming on the Trisha show, I have learned to make some changes in the way I run my castle.
Things have improved greatly in the kingdom. Trisha's helped me to learn to believe in myself, and that most of all, that I deserve respect.
I've learned that my wife is equal to me. And, you know, I saw some of the ways other people treated their wives, and in my heart, it made me feel that I was not that same person.
I think one of the best things that could have possibly happened out of coming to the show, it's the attitudes that are changing, especially where my son Daniel is concerned.
I learned that women are just not used to cooking and cleaning. They have more important role in life. I learned to respect my mom more than I did before.
At this point, I'm excited for the future of the kingdom and how we're doing things. And I'm excited about the man that I'm going to be in the future.
Look back on a man with five. That's right, five wives. Thank you.
pad.
Yes.
Today, Hong has an announcement to make about the state of his marriage. Shocking guest update.
Waiting for...
Coming up, if you have the opportunity to speak your mind to one of today's guests face to face, who would it be? Call in and voice your vote. Later.
Courtney's accusing me of planting a gun in her car.
Now you see my mom's finger crying? Shocking guest update. Time to voice your vote.
We're definitely going to get a divorce.
I have learned to make some changes.
If you have the opportunity to speak your mind to one of today's guests, who would it be? Call in now and voice your vote. Call 1-855-2-TRISHA and let us know whose side you're on. Provided by... Up next, if you have the opportunity to speak your mind to one of today's guests face to face, who would it be? Call in and voice your vote. Shocking guest updates. Time to voice your vote.
We're definitely going
to
get a divorce.
I have learned to make some changes.
If you have the opportunity to speak your mind to one of today's guests, who would it be? Call in now. Call 1-855-2-TRISHA and let us know whose side you're on. And while you're on the phone, you will also receive some valuable offers. That's 1-855-2-TRISHA. What's your vote? Promotional consideration provided. To speak your mind to one of today's guests face to face, who would it be? Would it be Logan? Eric Floyd? Yeah. Oh, what about King JB? Yeah. Okay, you can voice your vote at 1-855-2-TRISHA. We'll be right back.